feels good.
Yeah,
so how's it feel to be an All-American?
You know, we,
feels good, for sure. Yeah. I mean, it's truly an honor. That's one thing that I wanted for myself in the beginning of the season. That was one goal that I set for myself. So, honored to be in and, yeah, waiting for that plaque.
Is there, when you come up that walk, some guys like touch certain ones or spots or whatever, was there anything for you?
Yeah, Tyler Lewis, that's for sure. Every time I go down, I touch that one.
Why Tyler Lewis?
Just because he like set the tone for like Tongans. You see there's a lot of like Samoans, Hawaiians up there, so yeah, he was like the first Tongan person on there, so I want to follow that. No, just playing ball. I'm undecided.
We'll see what happens.
Is there a timeline or process that you have in terms of making that decision?
I'll announce after the bowl game for sure. Yeah.
Was there any thought to maybe not playing in the bowl game at all?
Oh no, I'm for sure playing no matter what. Yeah, can't leave my brothers out there.
Do you think this could be very possible your last college game though? Is that kind of freaking you out?
I mean, yeah, that's something I gotta consider, but yeah, just focus on the game, and when the time comes to make the decision, I'll make the decision.
The team that has lost the Pac-12 championship game has never won its bowl game. Can you just talk about kind of the mindset of kind of resetting and getting motivated for this game after a tough loss?
Yeah, just gotta go in and focus on Tulane. Where y'all going? Ain't nobody talk to them. That's crazy. But yeah, we're just gonna focus on the game, you know, just go out there and just play ball, like leave everything on the field, the last game of the season, so just gotta leave everything on the field.
What were the biggest takeaways from the Utah loss?
Just staying just keep fighting, even though we didn't have that momentum that take us back, like bring us back up. But you just got to keep fighting. That's it.
Did you feel like it was an advantage or disadvantage with them seeing you the second time? Was there stuff that they threw at you guys that maybe you didn't see the first time?
I mean, I guess, yeah. But when we come into the second half, we know what they've been doing throughout the game. So I mean, yeah. But like we adjust to that stuff. So we just gotta go out there and execute.
Is it hard to have such a long break in between, you know, a disappointing loss like that and your next game? It's almost like a month in between games.
Yeah, for sure. Especially because, like, this is my first bowl game, so I don't know how this is going, like, how this break is going to be for us. But, I mean, we're out here practicing, working our way back up, and we're going to be hitting. So,
Kalen also got All-American status. Can you just talk about where he's improved the most and kind of maybe what you're proudest of with him?
I mean, the biggest thing about him is just his swag. Like, that's one thing. Like, I see Kalen on the field and just, like, you know, loose and swagged out and just playing ball. And that's how I want to approach. I don't want to do too much, think too much. I just want to be out there, just play ball, have fun.
How did you hear about winning?
Oh my bad. Congrats to him though, man. He worked. He's working. He's gonna be a great leader for this team in the future, and I'm excited for him to see what he's gonna continue to do because he's that guy for sure.
How'd you hear about winning Polynesian College Football Player of the Year?
How did I hear about it?
Yeah, did they reach out to you?
I think Miss Katie told me. Yeah, Miss Katie told me. I think the day of. But yeah, it's truly an honor to win the award, but. We just gotta focus on Tulane. Just get the work.
What's it been like being on the banquet circuit and going to all these awards ceremonies and all this stuff?
Yeah, it's been crazy. Especially because like we went right after the game, after the loss. So it was tough being up there and just talking to a bunch of people. But I mean, I had to go through it. So it was a good experience for sure. Shout out to all the awards and all the committees that helped me out and supported my family too. So.
Did you meet anybody cool that stood out?
Will was a really good. I mean, I was with him the whole week. Like, we was in Charlotte. We was in Charlotte, Houston. He came out here to Orange County. So, I mean, I was with him the whole trip. So, he was a good dude to talk to. And, yeah.
What are you proudest of?
I'm most proud, like, personal or, like, team-wise? I'd say just continue to improve. Like, that's one thing I take. I just want to keep getting better. That's it. And I know I know there's still more to go, and I know this that I can improve way more than what I did this year.
How do you think about this season, this defense? I want you to kind of really take that next jump and national stack league, all that stuff.
In, like, the D-line, what the D-line doing?
Just what you guys were doing defensively, what you did personally, what kind of match you think that next year was just
sitting there? I'd say, yeah, just my D-line, the defense, the whole defense. I mean, I don't get sacks if my guys aren't covering the back end. I don't get sacks if my D-line is pushing the pocket. And, yeah, it's really because of them.
How do you see this year, kind of what you guys did on the field? And then also the attention that you guys have gotten individually, the Heisman, All-Americans, all that, serving as sort of a launch point in Lincoln's first year and moving forward next year and years to come.
Yeah, hopefully everybody sees that and wants to come next season. We're trying to rebuild. We're trying to elevate and, just bring more guys in and try to win a championship. That's what we're here to do, and that's what we got to achieve.
All right, thanks, Tuli.
Thank you.
Have a good one.